A Melbourne suburb set alight. It's the fifth tobacco store attack this week. In Victoria, more than 30 businesses have been torched since March.
Melbourne's tobacco war has exploded again.
Altona's tobacco store has been destroyed in a targeted firebombing.
And another tobacco shop has been destroyed by fire in Melbourne's north.
And what we've identified is linkages between the illicit tobacco trade and outlaw motorcycle gangs.
It's called Earn or Burn. Gangs extorting small tobacco shops, forcing business owners to sell their smuggled smokes or else go up in flames. Over the weekend, Victorian police arrested five people, believed to be linked to the Finks Outlaw Motorcycle Gang, one of the two rival gangs allegedly behind this trail of destruction.
This is a substantial series of arrests. It's important to understand that it was an OMCG group that's been behind this.
Last financial year, Australian Border Force seized 1.7 billion illegal cigarettes and 867 tonnes of loose-leaf chop-chop tobacco.
And certainly is a significant problem that we're seeing at the border.
Australia is one of the most expensive countries in the world to be a smoker. The average price for a pack of smokes is $50. But consumers can illegally purchase a pack of 20 for as little as 20 bucks. The majority of these illicit cigarettes come from China, Southeast Asia, or the United Arab Emirates. They're legitimate products, but when they're smuggled into the country, they have no health warnings and no duty is paid, costing the country billions in lost tax.
Yes, this is a rip-off of taxpayers, but it's also undermining our public health, and it is a funding source for organised crime gangs who are using this revenue to fund drug trafficking, to fund sex trafficking and more.
Today, the federal government announced a major crackdown to stem the illicit tobacco trade.
$188 million in additional resourcing to the Australian Border Force for a comprehensive crackdown on illegal cigarettes and illegal tobacco. These additional resources will help shut down this illegal trafficking at its source.
The funding will see Border Force introduce new technological aids like AI to help with detection and disruption.
This funding will enable the Australian Border Force to work offshore, working with international partners, including our customs and law enforcement regulatory agencies, to be able to stem the flow of illicit tobacco coming towards the Australian border before it even reaches our shores.
But is this enough to end the tobacco turf war?
Former AFP and Australian Border Force officer Rohan Pike created and led the ABF's tobacco strike team in 2015. Rohan, five attacks this week, 30 since March. Why is this escalating so much?
Over the past 12 months, there have been new organised crime gangs seeing the benefits of getting into this crime type. And this is an old-fashioned turf war where they're trying to get their product to market and they're trying to take over some of the retail outlets in order to do that. Sometimes that involves violence.
How much pressure are the small business operators coming under?
Oh, enormous pressure. Obviously, there've been not only the firebombings, but murders. There was one just across the road from your Channel 10 studios here in Melbourne late last year. So they obviously mean business, and the storeholders know that when they're threatened, they can carry out those threats.
And we're seeing a lot of this happen in Victoria. Is it also happening elsewhere?
Yeah, it's happening in regional and metro Victoria, but also up on the Gold Coast. There have been about half a dozen firebombings up there. So it is a national phenomenon, I guess. Of course, people are selling illicit tobacco all over Australia. It's just that they're doing so under the radar in some of the other states.
So all of the statistics suggest that smoking is actually reducing. There's been very long-term campaign to steer Australians away from it. Why are the gangs so interested in tobacco?
Because the illicit tobacco market is actually increasing. People are moving away from the legal product. Why would you buy a $50 packet when you can get a similar product for only $20? So that side of the market is actually increasing, and there are enormous profits to be made by these gangs with very little risk.
Why is it so low risk? Why are they unlikely to be caught?
Most of the law enforcement focus has been around the border, and these new measures that have been announced today also talk about the border and, in fact, even offshore, whereas a lot of the crime occurs post-border. The border force can't stop everything that comes in, and post-border there's been a lack of enforcement for many years.
Do you think this crackdown is going to deter bikies?
Well, I don't think so, no, in a word. The driver is still there, and the driver, of course, is the price of tobacco. The government is actually increasing the price of tobacco, which will further fuel the black market. So while that driver's there, the incentive for these gangs to move into the market will also stay there, and $47 million per year, when it's a multi-billion dollar industry, is probably not enough. Although it's a good start, it shows that the government are listening and are starting to do something about it, but it's going to take a much bigger commitment to really crack down and deter these crime gangs.
And this crackdown comes after the January 1st crackdown on vaping. Is that feeding into this?
According to the Deputy Commissioner of the ABF today, the gangs that are involved in vaping are also involved in illicit tobacco. So anything that targets one crime type will naturally feed into the other. So yes, both of those crimes will be affected and hopefully deter people from entering it.
Rohan Pike, thanks for your time.
You're welcome.